tips to get started with Xero Payroll. Whether you're switching from another system or getting started with payroll software for the first time, you'll need your organisation GST number, your next payroll payment date, your pay frequencies, that is how often you pay your employees, and your list of pay items. These are the earnings, deductions, and reimbursements relating to your employees. To begin setting up your payroll settings, you'll need to assign yourself or your payroll administrator the payroll admin user role in Xero. This user role has full payroll access, and only users with this access can set up employees, prepare and process pay runs, and run payroll reports. Next, add your payroll organization settings. You can choose the bank account that you'll be making the payroll payments from. The next three fields are used to record payroll in your Xero accounting system. Xero provides default payroll accounts ready to go, saving you from having to set them up. The PAYE liability account records the pay-as-you-earn tax, or PAYE for short. This is the tax calculated on salary and wage payments for employees and is paid to Inland Revenue. The wages expense account records the cost of employing staff to the business before PAYE tax is deducted. And the wages payable account is for recording the amount paid out to your employees after PAYE tax has been deducted. Each time you post a pay run, Xero updates and keeps your accounts in sync, saving you manual work. You can then easily report and track the costs and taxes related to your employees. Your organization's IRD number goes into the employer IRD number field. If your gross annual PAYE taxes, including your employer superannuation contribution tax, or ESCT for short, is less than $500,000 per financial year, then select small in the employer size field. If it's over $500,000 per financial year, select large. Be aware that small employers only need to pay taxes monthly by the 20th of the following month. Large employers need to pay taxes twice a month. The opening balances date is the date that you'll start monthly reporting to Inland Revenue from Xero. So choose the month in which your next pay run payment date falls. For example, if your next payment date is 24th of November, then you'd select 1st of November. If your Xero organisation has tracking categories set up to report by department, cost centre or region, you can select it here. This will allow you to track the payroll costs for the different areas of your business and filter and group payroll and financial reports. Upload your company logo to make your payslips look professional or to add a touch of colour. Calendars let you set up different pay periods for your employees. You may pay some employees weekly, while paying others fortnightly, bi-monthly, or monthly. Set up as many pay frequencies as you need. Give your pay calendars unique and descriptive names, making it easier for you to recognise when processing pay runs. Categorise, track, and calculate how you pay each employee. This includes any earnings, deductions, superannuation, which is KiwiSaver, and leave using pay items. These will be seen on payslips and are used to calculate employee payments and any taxes. Xero includes defaults for all your normal pay items, like ordinary pay or salary, holiday pay, ACC, KiwiSaver contributions, and more. However, you can set up any non-typical pay items for the different earnings, deductions, and reimbursements for your employees. For example, you pay employees a commission or bonus for hitting sales targets, and you want to keep track of this separately from their ordinary wages or salary. You'd set up a new earnings pay item and then select the commissions account code. This will provide a total amount of bonuses or commissions paid in the financial year to then help you forecast and budget for the next financial year. You can also change the account codes of the default pay items to itemize the earnings and deductions to meet your reporting needs.